The Fort Lewis JBLM Centennial Celebration included another special dedication and a ribbon cutting.
3, 2, 1, liftoff.
The plaque commemorates the Boulevard of Remembrance, the planting of 660 trees along Old Highway 99. In 1929, the ladies of the Tacoma Garden Club raised over $12,000 and planted the trees to commemorate the soldiers who died in World War I. The plaque stands on the very spot of the original ceremony.
1, 2, 3.
Next came the grand reopening of the Fort Lewis Army Museum.
This museum is going to be a shining star of the Northwest, and you're going to see enormous amounts of regional visitation here.
The museum occupies the old Red Shield Inn, a World War I hotel operated by the Salvation Army. The exhibits and the building have been renovated to tell the history of Fort Lewis and the United States Army.
I think it's absolutely great. I was here before all the changes, and seeing how different it is now, it's astonishing. It looks amazing.
Included in the renovation is a new public gate and parking area off Stillicum DuPont Road.
It's great that people are able to get in here, access it, and see the history, particularly on this 100th anniversary of World War I and the establishment of Camp Lewis.
As more exhibits are added, the museum will also provide history training for JBLM soldiers.
These are closer to what my dad was wearing when he was in the military, in the same trunk, same type. Well, he didn't have to sleep in those because he was a high-ranking NCO, but when he was processed, I'm sure he did. So it's a little trip down memory lane for me.
Learn more about the museum and when you can visit on the museum website.